Dzień dobry Państwo. Dzień dobry Torun. My name is Jeroen van den Oever. I will speak in English. Znam trochę po polsku, mówić pa. But not enough. Thank you. We are going to talk now about imago, about the image. The image of the nursing home. And I think this is, and I will do that by comparing the situation in the Netherlands, where I live and work, compared to Poland, a country which I know a little bit. First of all, an image of a dom opieki, of a nursing home, is not an easy thing to understand. There are many factors which influence the image of your home. And it's also depending from who is looking at your home. So for everybody, an image of a building can be different, of a home can be different. The question is also if you can change your image. The image of nursing homes in the Netherlands is not always positive, and it can be complex. So I would like to tell you a little bit about the learning points we have in the Netherlands about image of nursing homes. First of that, this is the company I work for in the Netherlands. I'm an economist from study. I worked in the healthcare insurance industry in the Netherlands, and I work now for a company which is called Fundis, where we have 4,000 home care clients, some 19 nursery homes, home care shops, revalidation units, and some 4,500 people who work in our group, and the turnover of 145 million euro. And I lived for 4 years in Warsaw. What we do in our group is we provide nursing home care, normal home care, the facilities, technological facilities people need, revalidation. Those are the main activities of what we do in the Netherlands in our company. Before I go into the comparison of experience in the Netherlands on nursing homes, I would like to specify something about the quantities and the differences between what we do in the Netherlands in this kind of care. In this picture, you see, first of all, what is the healthcare spending, the total healthcare spending in the Netherlands and in Poland. And this is in percentage. And you see that if you compare it in what we, GDP, in gross domestic product, then it's 6% towards 10%. If you look to the number of spendings from private money from people, you see that Poland pays much more to the healthcare part than in the Netherlands. So the bigger part in the Netherlands is paid by public insurance systems. For the long-term care, not hospital care, but the long-term care, in Poland this is about 6%. In the Netherlands it's very, very high. We have 25%. One quarter of all the money we spend in healthcare in the Netherlands is going to this kind of long-term care. And if you see to the hospital care, it's about the same. So this is one of the reasons that our system is so very expensive in the Netherlands. If you look to the residential care, then we see that the amount of money which is going to care inside a building, then you see that in the Netherlands this is about 25%, and in Poland it's very, very low. Of course, these are the official figures, official amount, because I know that there's also a lot of care given not through official systems, especially in Poland. If you look to the money side, so not to the percentage, but if you look to the number of euros between the Netherlands and Poland, you see that the total healthcare spending is about 700 euro for in Poland per capita, and in the Netherlands it's 4,269. So that's a very, very big difference. If you look to the long-term care spendings, it's very, very low in Poland, officially, 42 euros per capita. In the Netherlands, 1,000 euro. And if you look to the residential care inside care homes, then you see that it's almost nothing in Poland towards 1,000 euro in the Netherlands. It's a very, very big difference. Here there's a difference of 6 times, here there's a difference of 25 times, and here there's a difference of 100 times. So you could say we are lucky. I'm not sure if that's the case. But anyway, the difference is very huge to the Netherlands and Poland. Okay, now I would like to go into the comparison, looking to the image of nursing homes as we know it in the Netherlands, and let's look what is interesting for Poland. I'm looking from that to the level of the client, on the level of the organization, on the level of the marketplace, and from the level of the public system, and like the government can look at it. First of all, if you look to the person, you and your mother, and you bring your mother to a nursing home, this is, in our experience, not always, mostly not a positive experience. Everybody knows that you don't want to go to a nursing home, but at a certain moment, the family decides that mother should go to a nursing home. And this is a very, let's say, negative experience in itself. It's giving the picture of deprivation. It is giving the picture, the image of the last step in your life. Therefore, it's giving you guilt feelings in the family. Sisters, daughters, sons, mostly the oldest daughter in a family, who has this kind of guilt feelings that you bring your mother, who you knew that she never wanted to go there, you bring her to this nursing home. That's also giving all kind of tensions in a nursing home, because of this guilt, the family can be extremely critical on what is happening in a nursing home, and that gives sometimes tensions. That can also give tensions between the family and the doctors and the staff. Now, how to avoid this kind of negative feelings? That's important for us. First, the things we do in the Netherlands, for example, is trying to connect between the family and the clients way before people go to a nursing home. Even better is if to combine nursing home care with normal home care. This system of home care is not very well developed yet in Eastern Europe. But if you could connect a circle around the nursing home where you could get into contact, build a relationship with your future clients, this can reduce the negative feelings on the moment that you go to the nursing home. Very important, and former speakers talked about it also, is that you should reduce feelings of stress and sickness. There are many, many possibilities to have a very decent life in a nursing home by more personal attention. We normally formulate on the beginning of a relation with a new client in a nursing home, we make daily care programs. And we organize that together with the family. We use internet accessibility to an electronic client dossier so that family, even on a far distance, can see what is happening every day with mother. We appoint an account, kind of an account nurse, who is having the special role to have contact with the family. And we try also to provide home care, as I already said, at the home of the client before, way before. The second comparison level you can make on the organization. The origin of nursing homes in the Netherlands is hospital care. And that has, of course, a very institutional character. Therefore, in the history, nursery care is normally practiced as a medical care. A medical model with professionals around it. And the problem is that institutions have a lot of rules and have a lot of bureaucracy. For example, this makes also the feeling for family that they can visit the institute, for example, and drink a cup of coffee and go away. And they are not participating in the life of the home. What we try to say and try to do is to make smaller units with home-alike care. And we try to break off the institution. We try to break off the medical model. The well-being in a comfortable home is much more important. So, for example, we talk not about patients, we talk about clients, or inhabitants. We don't have white costumes. We have normal clothes on. And we try to be as home as possible. It's also important that the staff is working there not as a governor, but as a co-resident. It is the home of the family. It's the home of the people who live there and their family. Staff is working there. It's also a very important way of looking to a home like that. We try to include the family in the life of nursing homes. Maybe we could even go to a model that family is owning the nursing home. Then we go to the market of nursing homes, the third level. In the Netherlands, used to be nursing homes a public facility. More and more since 2014, we have now a possibility that there are also private homes. And people can choose between those homes. There are more facilities in the neighborhood. And this is also made the possibility to have segmentation in this kind of care. So we have houses where you pay nothing. You have a decent, a good care. But you have also houses where you pay more. So the prices in the Netherlands between, in Zegmar, for 1 month are between 600 and 4,500 euro to pay for 1 month. So of course, not everybody can pay that high price. The segmentation is in itself a politically difficult issue. But because of the fact that it's not affordable, that the public costs pay those houses completely, now people are open to have their own choice what kind of house they want and what kind of spending they have. Therefore, there is also more and more competition in the Dutch market for nursery homes. And we have also first international players from France and from Germany and from America who start this kind of service in the Netherlands. We also have now websites where you can choose, where you can see all kind of houses in the neighborhood, and you can look what is the prices and what is the kind of services, and you can compare it to each other. Our big problem in the Netherlands is the labor market. It's the same I heard yesterday from the taxi driver in Poland. But in the Netherlands, it is like so far that some nursing homes have to close or have to close a part of their beds. The problem of the staffing problem of educated nurses and caretakers is so huge that we expect in the next few years that the system in the Netherlands will come under pressure and that we might do other things. For example, try to, with family, to include more family help into the home. Because there will be not enough staff in the next 10, 15 years to help all old, frail people. Some suggestions here. For a nursery home, it's very important to have a clear image about what you stand for. You should make clear why it's better people come to you instead of a nursing home 5 kilometers further. So make clear what quality you have and provide. It's also very important to connect home care nurses and doctors, general practitioners, together with the nursing home. Those people are very important in your network. The general practitioner is the one who talks first with somebody with dementia, and that's also for the home care nurse. So there you should make a good network. It's very important to understand the different kinds of segments and care needs. As you know, there are 200 types of dementia, for example. And people with dementia have complete different kind of needs. And you could specialize in those needs. I've seen in Poland a lot of nursing homes where even are combined handicapped people with mental problems and people with dementia. That is for me very difficult to understand if that can give good care. And we should cooperate with other companies, other hospitals and nursing homes together to influence the labor market. We have to train more people who will become a nurse and a caregiver, because the problem of staffing in the future will be huge. Then the last level is the level of society and politics. Are nursing homes a public or a private thing? Maybe in Poland it's clear that it's private, but in the Netherlands it's not like that. And we have a huge discussion if we can stay on going to pay for such a high service. I showed you the numbers in the Netherlands. We pay a lot of money for residential care. Should we continue like that? And this makes also that we have very much attention from the press and from the politicians. Because the politicians think and say that nursery homes in the Netherlands are public possession. But they are, in reality, they are private. Because or they are privately owned, or they are foundations. And the foundations, that's not the same as the state. So this kind of problem is for us important. It gives also a negative image, because the well-being of people in a nursing home is a very important thing, of course, but it's also a very easy thing for journalists to jump on if something happens. And that means that issues like that can be on the front page of your journal. And then it comes also in the parliament. And this makes also that, for example, my kind of job, people who are in a management of these kind of companies are very vulnerable, because we cannot do anything right, it looks like. And that's, in the Netherlands, quite a problem. Because of this discussion in the Netherlands is also, we had the strange thing that the parliament was forced last year to decide to even spend more money because of these negative signs in the news. And again, we have a budget problem in the Netherlands. The number of people with dementia will grow fast in the next 10 years. So I think we have quite some problems. Well, suggestions. As Eastern European systems have on this moment almost no welfare system for elderly, by the public, I mean, I think that probably because of the budget problems also here, is not expected to become one in the near future. Therefore, I think that in Poland and also in other Eastern European countries, there will be probably more privately owned nursing homes. And they have a future. They have a real future, I think. But they have to improve quality. It should be not a medical model they use, but they should be a model of quality of life and well-being. It should be homes with a clear segment in the market, with a clear quality imago. It should be houses where family have an important role. That's important in the Eastern European situation, that family always have been important. So don't let the institutions take over. Make the connection with family. And what is very important is train your staff on hospitality and on empathy, both very important qualities. And last but not least, influence the journalists and the press and the politicians on the good added value of these kind of houses. My conclusion is, it might be the case that in Western Europe they spend much more on nursing homes, but it's not always a better world. Our system is not paradise. We have our problems also, although we spend much more. I think that it's a good thing that in Poland and in other countries in the East, we find our own path of development of very good nursing home care. Thank you very much.